right now in society, we are terrifically concerned about privacy. And we're worried about our emails being read and our telephone calls being listened to. But what if your brain could be listened to as well? The technology to pick up brain activity is here today. There's a new set of them that are coming online, which are wearable EEG devices, electroencephalograph devices, which give you real-time brain activity information. Corporations are already thinking about how to use this technology to their benefit. So car insurance companies are utterly fascinated with the idea of being able to integrate it into drivers wearing it while driving because it can pick up drowsiness. And so governments have started to explore, for example, whether or not it could be used for lie detection purposes. So is it useful? There's something called a P300 wave, which is a wave that's supposed to show, a brain wave that's supposed to show recognition in the brain. And if you outfit a person with one of these EEG devices and ask them a series of questions in order to detect whether or not they're telling the truth, that P300 wave is supposed to light up to give you an indication of whether they're telling the truth or lying. So if you wanted to know, the emotive state of a particular group, maybe you want to find out if a riot is about to happen and you want to figure out if a lot of people in that area have high alert level, you might be able to send in, you know, troops or send in police in order to avoid a riot from happening or disband a riot from happening. But most concerning for people is if the government can listen in on even what's happening in your brain, the likelihood that that really chills people being able to think freely. So first, I think that we need to recognize something called cognitive liberty. We need to recognize that freedom of speech and different types of freedoms that are really targeted at free exercise of association and speech really need to back up a step, and we need to be much more concerned with freedom of thought. There should be a right to self-determination, that is to determine what happens to your brain. Can you be forced to take drugs? Can you be forced to be listened into? These technologies to be able to access ourselves and access our brains are incredibly exciting. They hold extraordinary promise for health, extraordinary promise for really knowing ourselves. I think it's important that we make room for the technology to develop and to provide enough support in order for them to flourish. But we have to recognize that there's always a potential dark side or misuse of technology, and we have to safeguard against it before that misuse actually occurs.